Thus it came to pass, in a dream as mythical to all Greeks as Achilles defeating the Trojans, at this one glorious moment in time, Alexander was loved by all. But in the end, I believe Babylon was a far easier mistress to enter than she was to leave.
Aristotle may have called them barbarians, but he never saw Babylon.
We've only dreamed.
We have enough gold here to support another 3 generations of Macedonian armies.
Macedonia would soon corrupt, Cassander. Wealth in great quantities brings the crows.
Not for the men who fought, I trust.
We'll pay them well, Antigonus, but not as mercenaries for future services.
Now you sound like Philip.
Philip never saw Babylon.
No, he didn't, if I did.
Alexander, I know you think me a stiff old sod, but whatever our differences, know this day, your father will be very proud of you.
Come and say hello to Gladys.
Thank you, Parmenia. I ask you to forgive me my own anger, my pride. They too blind me.
Magnificent Mainland work from the last century. The Golden Age, Alexander. Worth much to Athens and to our alliances.
Take back what is ours, but spare what belongs to the Persians.
Yes. We're the richest men to walk the earth, my friends.
Not if we keep giving it all away.
The grandsons of goat herders, we now rule 2 million square miles. But none of you fear that this great fortune may drive us all to destruction.
You overvalue us. For as long as Darius breathes, he's the legitimate king of Asia, and I, but the king of air.
But he has no power, Alexander. He's lost in the mountains with no arm.
As long as he's lost, Philotas, he can be believed in. Only when he's found will it be decided.
Seems you've already made up your mind, Alexander.
We must finish what we failed to do at Gaugamela, Parmenion. We must hunt Darius down, if it be, to the ends of Earth.
That was not your father's mission.
And I am not my father.
Come on. Have you so quickly forgotten? Fortune favors the bold.